Welcome back to Inside Games Digest, the only show brave enough to talk about the next Switch. Switch 2, the Switch Pro, whatever it is, we're going to talk about it.
That's right. Did the next Switch already leak? Well, as the best-selling console is about to turn 6 years old, Nintendo has been extremely quiet about any possible successor.
Yeah, they don't want to freak investors out, I think, because people speculate the next one's going to be big, and we're all waiting. We want it. So there's been a lot written about the next Nintendo Switch, mostly because people want to know. But thanks to some regulatory filings, we might have finally gotten proof that a new console is actually for real in the works, really, this time.
Yeah, this comes from the UK's Competition and Markets Authority. You might remember their report from a couple of weeks ago. They've been looking into the proposed Microsoft-Activision-Blizzard merger.
Yep, buried deep in the appendices of the report, there's a section that talks about services that could plausibly compete with the cloud features of Microsoft's Xbox Game Pass.
Probably not because it's actually going to compete realistically, but it does bring up Nintendo Switch's online service.
Yeah, in referencing it, the appendix notes that Nintendo Switch Online, quote, is only available on the Nintendo Switch device and redacted.
Whoa, wait, whoa.
What is it?
That's the name of the new Switch system, redacted.
rolls off the tongue.
Yeah, yeah. That and would definitely indicate that Nintendo has another console in the works. And we assume it's redacted because obviously Nintendo doesn't want it announced yet.
Or alternative theory. Not that I want this to be true, but maybe they're working on bringing it to mobile phone and they don't want to reveal that just yet.
Wow. Oh, wow. Okay. Sure.
But I don't want that. It's a new Switch.
Headline. Tear it up.
I'm no Jeff Grubb. They're not going to make headlines off of random things I say. But like we said, Switch is about to turn 6 years old. Nobody wants to play Tears of the Kingdom on that thing, but we all will. And yeah, considering it's dated hardware, it's just, it's getting chunky. It's getting rough. So while Nintendo isn't saying anything publicly, it's certain they've got something under wraps. They're always working on something.
All right, next story. Hogwarts Legacy runs better on the PS5 than the Xbox Series X. Let the console wars, let's do it all over again.
Begun the console wars have, is what you were trying to say. According to a Digital Foundry tech review of Hogwarts Legacy on next-gen consoles, it runs better on the PlayStation 5 than it does on the Xbox Series X.
Digital Foundry's Richard Ledbetter said the game had, quote, troubling frame rate issues on Xbox consoles.
Uh-oh. Meanwhile, the PS5 version in performance mode manages a quote nearly locked 60 FPS and the fidelity mode achieves a consistent 30 FPS that is quote very difficult to drop at all.
But performance mode on Xbox Series X, on the other hand, is very shaky. That's a quote, with quote dropped frames being a near constant.
Oof. Well, now Ledbetter didn't say the PS5 version was perfect, but did say that it was clearly substantially more stable across its main visual options.
Oh, I already got on the GameSpot forums to argue my case. I love the console wars. They're back.
This is Game Pass's fault somehow. Bah.
The game is out now for PC, PS5, and Xbox Series X and S, but it's due out on last-gen consoles in the months to come, and I'm sure it's going to be worse on those, so get ready for that.
Our next story is kind of sad, a little melancholy, marking the passage of time. The head of Tango Gameworks is stepping down soon.
Yeah, the founder of the developer, Shinji Mikami, who directed the Evil Within franchise, is leaving after 12 years.
Bethesda confirmed the departure in a tweet saying, quote, we wish Mikami-san well in the future and are excited by what lies ahead for the talented developers at Tango.
Now, Shinji Mikami is a pretty legendary game developer. He started at Capcom, where he's credited with creating the original Resident Evil. He left in 2006 and joined Platinum Games to direct the third-person action shooter Vanquish, where you have rocket knees. It's pretty cool.
And in 2010, he founded, of course, Tango Gameworks, which made Ghostwire Tokyo and the surprise hit Hi-Fi Rush earlier this year.
We salute you, Mikami-san.
Kind of a shame, too. I feel like Tango was just starting to blow up. Maybe he's starting a new studio, and we'll have even cooler games. Who knows?
All right, on to the next story. Valve traps and bans 40,000 Dota 2 cheaters.
I love this stuff. I love it so much. Internet honeypots are one of my favorites. All right. Cheaters in video games aren't anything new. Anyone who's played CSGO for more than 5 minutes knows that. But Valve had a unique way of smoking out 40,000 Dota 2 accounts who were up to no good.
Yeah, the bad actors were permabanned after they used third-party software to cheat by looking at internal data in the Dota client that is not visible during normal gameplay.
In a statement, Valve said after realizing what method the cheaters were using, they released a patch and created a trap, which they love to do.
Valve said this patch created a honeypot, a section of data inside the game client that would never be read during normal gameplay but could be read by these exploits. Each of the accounts banned today read from this secret area in the client, giving us extremely high confidence that every ban was well deserved.
They read banned books. They gotta go.
Got you, motherfucker.
While the the bandwave was substantial, Valve says it is just part of an ongoing campaign to stop cheaters. They wrote, if you are running any application that reads data from the Dota client as you're playing games, your account can be permanently banned from playing Dota. So there you go. Just, you got to be careful. Don't cheat.
No.
All right, let's do an extremely fast review. I feel like Samus, when I was playing this, she remembers me playing this back in 2002, and she's just like, dude, what happened? You okay, man? Steam some vegetables.
The first time we got the gravity suit was great.
And now look at you.
Now I live with a gravity suit.
Those Metroid zingers, love them.
Up next, what's coming up this week in video games?
First up, we got Scars Above. This is a challenging sci-fi third-person action-adventure shooter combining the rewarding feeling of overcoming difficulty with a compelling and intricate story set in a mysterious alien world to explore. Scars Above launches on PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, and PC on February 27th.
Next up, Catan Console Edition. It delivers the original, authentic Catan experience and lets you play with up to four friends. No two games are the same. With variable board setups, you'll experience a different Catan every time you play. Quick play allows you to get into the action quickly, boot up a board, and start playing with preset roads and settlements. Comes to PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, and Xbox One, February 28th.
Up next, we've got Brock the Investigator, the very first punch and click. Brock is an innovative adventure mixed with beat-em-up and RPG elements in a grim world where animals have replaced mankind. What kind of detective will you be? Comes to PS4, PS5, Xbox One, and Switch on March 1st.
I gotta tell you, I'm intrigued. That's an interesting description. Leap is a fast-paced multiplayer first-person shooter featuring epic large-scale battles, each with players armed to the teeth. Fight for either the United Earth Defense Force Coalition or the rebel Exo-Terrans. Whoever pays the most wins your trigger finger and excessive arsenal. Leap comes out on the PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, and Xbox One on March 1st.
Next up, Mayhem in Single Valley. In this fast-paced, puzzle-loaded action-adventure, you'll juggle housework, zombie hordes, family dinners, and radioactive squirrels. Hate it when that happens. Oh, and you have to prevent the end of the world while keeping everyone from finding out it was all your fault. Love it. Comes to PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, Xbox One, and the Switch March 2nd.
Up next, we got No Longer Home. No Longer Home is a game about letting go of the life you've built due to circumstances beyond your control. Immerse yourself in the lives of Bo and Ao and learn about their dreams, frustrations, and fears. Welcome the magic of the everyday and somewhat extraordinary. It comes to PS5 and PS4 March 3rd.
Man, the trailer for that game probably has like a ukulele in it. A little stomp clap. Finally, we got Wolong Fallen Dynasty. This is a new dark fantasy Three Kingdoms action RPG from Team Ninja, the developers of Nioh. Wolong Fallen Dynasty is a dramatic, action-packed story of a nameless militia soldier fighting for survival in a dark fantasy version of the later Han Dynasty where demons plague the Three Kingdoms. Players fight off deadly creatures and enemy soldiers using swordplay based on the Chinese martial arts, attempting to overcome the odds by awakening the true power from within. Wolong Fallen Dynasty comes out on PC, PS4, PS5, Xbox One, and Xbox Series X and S on March 3rd.
That is all the gaming news we got for you this week, guys. But first up, I believe we have some patrons to thank.
That's right. Regulus, Aaron Fraze, Spirit Bear, and Maurice Thompson. Thanks for supporting Inside Games.
Docs360, Cash Putnam, UESC Battleroid, and Jabers87. Thank you all very, very much. We'll see you next time.